it's been, is it 10 months since the government took over? Yep. So the question is, what do Kenyans think about how this government is performing? What are their main achievements and failures? Who's the best performing public or senior public official? And then what you've done is also ask Kenyans to give a score to the president. How is he performing in terms of fulfilling the campaign promises? So let's start with the positive. What are the achievements? And this is the June 2023 study. Top mention, although the percentages are not really high, in terms of an achievement, is that the Kenya Kwanza government has set up the Hustler Fund, and which is known to be sorting out what you call the bottom-up economy at only 10%. Then the next one is reducing the cost of fertilizer and other agricultural outputs at 8%. However, if you go down the chart, you'll see those who say that the Kenya Kwanza government has achieved nothing is 51%. That's a majority. And that's what you're seeing. A lot of mentions, but the percentages are very few. But 51% of Kenyans feel that the Kenya Kwanza government has achieved nothing since they got into power. Now, let's look at the NAN, analyzed by pro-opposition, pro-government, and so on. If you look at the green bar, it is a pro-opposition, and you can see 7% of the pro-opposition respondents feel that the Kenya Kwanza government has achieved nothing, whereas 31% of the Kenya Kwanza supporters or pro-government supporters feel that the government has achieved nothing. Again, let's look at a trend, because it's always good to look at are the sentiments changing or not. Now, in terms of achievements, when we did this study in March 2023, the top most mention was setting up the Hustler Fund, which was at 29%, but it has reduced in the June 2023 survey to 10%. That is a very big decline. If you look at the setting up the cost of fertilizer, it's moved from 5% to 6%. There's no difference there because the margin of error in our data is plus or minus 2%. Now let's look at the respondents who say nothing, meaning there's been no achievement. In March 2023, those who said that the Kenya Kwanza government had achieved nothing were 38%. If you look at the number that is giving mentions now, it is 51%. So you can see the inclination is saying, you know what, we elected you, we expected ABCD, there were many campaign promises, but the government has done nothing, according to Kenyans. And of course, this would explain why over half of Kenyans are thinking that the country is heading in the wrong direction. Let's look at the main failures of the Kenya Kwanza government. Again, linked to the reason why the country is heading in the wrong direction. And what we are seeing here, out of the total sample, 52% of Kenyans are saying that increased economic hardship is a reason why, or one of the things that they count as the failures of the Kenya Kwanza government so far. As we all know, both sides, whether it was Azimio or Kenya Kwanza, one of the key manifestos they had or campaign promises was sorting out the economy. But now that the Kenya Kwanza government got into power, over half of Kenyans are saying this is one of their failures. They have actually increased economic hardships for Kenya or for Kenyans. So again, here we're looking at the trend. And the mention of economic hardship has moved from 37% in March 2023 to 52% in June 2023. If you look at mentions of failed campaign promises or failure to deliver on the campaign promises, the mention has moved from 14% to 7%, and the list continues. But for us, what we are seeing in this data is that there's a link between how Kenyans are rating the government, the high cost of living and increased economic hardship. At the end of the day, government promises a lot, education, water, roads, and etc. But the thing that is at the top of everyone, Kenyan, or majority of them, is the increased economic hardship.